Today, many witnessed the official launch of the region's fast-growing fashion event, Haute Couture. The event forms part of the arts component of the St. Lucia Jazz and Arts Festival. In the past two editions, the St. Lucia Tourist Board has been the principal organizer. This year, the SLTB sent out a request for proposals, and after a vetting process of a critical review of responders, the team of She Magazine, headed by Mrs. May Wayne, and Landmark Productions, headed by Mr. Adrian Auger, will be the hosts of the Haute Couture event.
What we will be seeing is a reflection of fashion from the perspective of art. So it's no longer just, you know, a display of beautiful garments, which of course is an integral part, but you'll be seeing it from the perspective of an art form. And that makes this event one of the signature components of the arts edition within the Jazz and Arts Festival. So if you have never been to it, or if you have seen it before, what you will be seeing this year is far different from what we have staged in the past.
Now in its third year, Haute Couture is a platform to showcase local talent.
Beauty, as they say, is in the eye of the beholder. And it is with this sentiment that the fashion industry has created a world of all things beautiful, eccentric, innovative, and trend-setting. It has brought me much joy to put together a cast of male and female St. Lucian models who capture the true essence of the beautiful diversity that make up our people. We are, of course, the Helens and Troys of the West. After being a part of the Haute Couture casting team for a third year, witnessing the passion, drive, and desire of our models to excel in this sector reignites an enthusiasm that won't soon wear off. They return year after year, obviously better, and it makes me proud knowing that they've used what they've learned from the time invested in them at Haute Couture to hone their skills.
One of the driving forces behind Haute Couture from the inception is the publisher of popular She magazine, Mrs. May Wayne.
Even as we celebrate 36 years of independence, today we embrace all cultures, despite the many political unrest in other parts of the world. We have invited to the Haute Couture runway the most seasoned designers from the Caribbean and beyond. My team has brought together 20 of the leading designers from St. Lucia, Guadeloupe, Guyana, Trinidad. We even have two lines from my hometown, my region, the Middle East, represented by Turkey. We are especially excited to have with us the winner of Project Runway Season 9, Trinidad's Ayana Ayongchi. For those of you who followed her, she was the highest rated season, and she is also on the cover of She. This will be Ayana's first runway appearance since her historic win in the Caribbean. I feel especially excited today about Haute Couture, knowing that Haute Couture is on trend. It has its finger on the pulse, especially is what is happening today in the world of politics.
Cuba will also be part and parcel of the event, and the ambassador to St. Lucia declares his excitement.
When Ms. May Wayne told me she had built this wonderful show once before, I was really excited about the way in which she was impacted by this cultural and artistic representation. I think after looking at many pictures and videos and lots of information about the show, that this is a show that is genuine, it's bold, and it's creative. I welcome very much the opportunity of Cuba being part of the St. Lucia Extraordinary Jazz and Arts Festival. I do think it is a very important part of our friendship and of our common place within the Caribbean to have these cultural and artistic exchanges. And I am very happy about this opportunity. I am sure we have already been in touch with the organizers in Cuba and the show in Cuba. They are also very, very excited to come to the very beautiful country of St. Lucia and to be in touch with the very beautiful people of St. Lucia.
Adrian Auger of Landmark Productions says after only 3 years, the standards of Haute Couture has exceeded all expectations.
Very, very quickly, I want to make a few points. Number one, the thing is working. Don't mess with it. I believe that there is no other team that can bring this show to the quality and standard that has been achieved. And I'm appealing to the decision makers out there to please allow us to grow this show for the sake of the festival and the country and the fashion industry in St. Lucia. We're now at a point where people are foregoing other fashion events. In just 3 years, this thing has built to an international standard. You just have to go online and look at the pictures from 2014, and you would think that you are in Milan or Paris or New York. We can do it. We are doing it. We have done it. Please allow us to continue.
The Haute Couture Fashion for Freedom show will open its doors to the public at 7 p.m. on May 6 at the Johnson's Center at Rodney Bay. For the DBS News World, I am Alex Bousquet.